Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. MacMost is brought to you by the more than 300 people that support it through the MacMost Patreon campaign. You can find out how to become a part of that at MacMost.com/Patreon. So online I noticed a lot of people ask the question, when I download a file using Safari, how can I control where the file goes to? So we have a few methods to do this. First, you've got the default location. So when you see a link like this, you can click it and it will just download. Now if you go into Safari Preferences, under General, you can look here and there's File Download Location. And the default is the Downloads folder, which is in your home folder, and it's a folder unto itself. But you could also switch it to something else. So you can select Other here and choose any folder you want. You can choose the desktop. You can choose a specific folder in your Documents folder. And it's pretty easy to change. So if you have to download, say, 50 different documents for work and you want to put them in a special folder, you can change it to be that folder and then change it back to the Downloads folder after. You could also select Ask for each download. When you do that and you click on a download link, it's going to actually come up with a box here and you can specify where it goes and you can even change its name. So that's really handy. Now no matter what your default setting is, you can always change it on a per download basis. So you can, instead of just clicking on the link for download, you can control click, hold the control key down and click, or you know, on the trackpad and mouse you can use two fingers and click and you get the context menu. And the context menu for a download link is going to include download link file, which is the default location, but you can also do download linked file as. And if you select that, it's always going to come up with this dialog here so you can select the location. So I can change my preference and say I want it to go to the downloads folder by default, but still bring up the context menu, select download link file as, and select its location. So you get the best of both worlds. You can get occasional times when you want to save it to a special location or change its name before saving, and you can have a default location for most times. Now, this doesn't always work because web pages have a lot of variety in how they set up these links. There could be scripting and all sorts of things in these download links to control exactly what happens. So you don't always get a clean download link like I'm using here. Sometimes it's a little bit different. But most pages, if they're created correctly, really should give you a nice clean download link that will obey your default location and control clicking on it to select download linked file as, so you can save the file where you want.